What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. It's your boy Al in the building. I'm back with another video. First of all, I just want to apologize for the lack of consistency. I was taking summer classes this entire summer and I just had poor time management. In today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys 5 tips on how to survive your first year of engineering school. So if this is your first time to my channel, welcome to my channel. Please check out my other content. Click the subscribe button. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for the continued support. Without further ado, let's get into the video. This upcoming school year is going to be really different from previous school years because most everybody's going to be taking online classes. So the whole entire game is changed. The tips I'm going to give you guys still relate to an online setting. The first year is the foundation. You need to have a strong start so you can finish off strong. The first piece of advice to survive engineering school: make friends and introduce yourself to people. Making friends, it helps, number one, to expand your network. You first get into college and you don't know anybody, so you need to start building your network up because engineering is really, really hard to do by yourself. So having other people and other sources of knowledge to help you out along the way will increase your productivity, because studying with other people will help you to save time when you're struggling with something. And also, if you miss a lecture, you have people that you can lean on for the notes that you miss. So making friends and introducing yourself to people is important. Don't let your shyness get in the way of that. The next piece of advice I have a consistent routine. So have a routine of when you're gonna study, sleep, when you're gonna relax, a routine of when you're gonna wake up. You have a certain time you study every day. Most likely your body will adjust to that and be like, oh, it's time to study. If you stay consistent and you study when you need to study, you relax when you need to relax, technically it'll allow you to take weekends off, because you're not even supposed to be studying on weekends. Your weekends are for yourself to replenish after a long, hard weekend of school. Know your why. Why did you decide to study engineering? What is your purpose? What is your goal? Where do you see yourself in 5 to 10 years? Know the answers to all these questions, because it will help you out when you are having a lack of motivation. One thing I would recommend for you to do is write your goals down so you can always look at it every day, and you will know when those voices are in the back of your head telling you that you're not smart enough. You'll know, nope, I wrote it in my post-it note. This is where I'm going. I'm not giving up. I got this. I can't stress this enough. Think about where you want to end up in the future, because then you'll be able to take the steps and make the right moves you need to make in order to get there. And then you'll also be able to put the energy into the things that matter most. That's one thing I've been trying to think about. That's a hard question, I'm not gonna lie. Every day, even if it's for 15 minutes, just think about, where do I want to end up in the future? And eventually the answer will come up. Number 4, take initiative of your learning. The transition from high school to college is astronomical. In high school, whenever the teacher taught something to me, I would take it for all it's worth and I wouldn't even bother to do any outside research. But in college, that style of learning is not gonna work at all. You need to make sure that you're seeking additional resources, whether it's the internet, whether it's tutors, whether it's other students. Seek those additional resources, because I promise you, 9 times out of 10, there's a different way to do something. This will just help you to be a better learner, because ultimately in life, if you want to get ahead, you will eventually need to teach yourself some specialized knowledge. There's never an end to learning, if that makes sense. If you learn how to become a better learner, I promise you, you can learn how to do anything. I remember freshman year, when we were learning coding, it was so hard. I actually hated it. Now that I'm a junior right now, although I'm still terrible at coding, now I know how to go about the process of learning it, and it's not as bad as I thought it was freshman year. So yeah, it's a lifelong lesson. Know how to take stuff and simplify it into a way that makes sense to you. My 5th and final step: grab your notebook, pencil, paper. If you haven't been taking notes during this entire time, I feel sorry for you, because these are some gems. Step number 5 to surviving engineering school is to embrace failure. Everybody is going to fail at some point. And if you're watching this right now and you're like a second year student, third year, fourth year, fifth year, drop a comment about a time you failed. Like, let's be transparent with each other because we all failed. So it might not come in your first year. It might not even come to your senior year, but eventually you will fail. I remember personally for me, the first instance of failure I had was my freshman year, second semester, when I failed an exam. Like, when I tell you guys I failed the exam, I got 40%. Like, I failed the exam. What I'm trying to tell you is that you're going to fail, and you need to be prepared to fail, because when you fail, the most important thing is how are you gonna recover from that failure? Are you gonna let that failure bring you down and define the rest of the semester or the rest of your time in college? Or are you gonna let that failure be a catalyst to success? What are you gonna do, huh? People that aren't afraid to fail, those people are dangerous. Those are the CEOs, those are the startup founders, those are the millionaires. Once you learn how to embrace failure in anything, the sky is the limit. I tell you, the sky is the limit. But yeah, that's the fifth and final tip on how to survive engineering school. If you guys gain one piece of advice, I've officially done my job. If this video added value to you at all, click the subscribe button. Please drop a comment down below. I like reading comments, so please drop a comment down below. And I'll see you guys in the next video.